If the output of a circuit remains in a stable state where it can stay indefinitely, but on application of a trigger pulse at input of the circuit, its output switches to a quasi-stable state. It stays there for a given amount of time t and then returns back to its original stable state until the next trigger pulse is applied. Then the circuit is known as monostable multivibrator. Also, as it switches to the quasi-stable state only once for a single input pulse, the circuit is also known as one-shot. We can build a one-shot using 555 timer IC, a resistor and a capacitor. VCC and reset pins of the IC are connected to VCC. Ground pin is connected to ground. Control pin is connected to 0.01 microfarad capacitor and then to ground. Output is taken from the third pin of the IC. Second pin of the IC is given as input where trigger pulse is applied. Discharge and threshold pin, that are number 6 and 7 pin, are shorted together and connected to resistor and capacitor as shown. I have redrawn the same circuit with its internal circuit shown for easy understanding. Now let's say the output of 555 timer IC is pulled low initially and trigger pulse is high. As V output is equal to 0, Q1 transistor is in saturation and capacitor gets discharged completely through Q1. So voltage across capacitor is 0 initially. Now output of comparator 1 is 0 and that of comparator 2 is also 0. So the output remains same infinitely. This state is therefore called stable state. Now, if we apply a trigger pulse at pin number 2 of the IC, output of comparator 2 will be high and that of comparator 1 will be still low. So, the output of 555 will switch to high, Q1 goes to cutoff. Therefore, the capacitor C starts charging through resistor R with a time constant tau is equal to RC. After TP time, the trigger pulse switches to high again, so the output of comparator 2 goes back to 0 and that of comparator 1 is still 0. So the output remains in the previous state and C still charges. As the voltage across capacitor crosses 2 VCC by 3, the comparator 1's output switches to logic high and that of comparator 2's still remains low. So 555's output is pulled to a logic low and Q1 transistor comes back to saturation as it was initially and capacitor starts to discharge rapidly through transistor Q1. Now the voltage across capacitor and the trigger pulse both are same as they were initially, so the output remains in the same stable state until another trigger pulse occurs. The time t for which the output of the 555 IC switches to a quasi-stable state is important to us. So let's find the time. The charging of capacitor is given by the equation Vc at time t is equal to Vcc times 1 minus e to power minus t upon RC. After a time t, voltage across capacitor reaches 2 VCC by 3. Therefore, 2 VCC by 3 is equal to VCC times 1 minus e to power minus t upon RC, which gives t is equal to RC ln 3. This t is equal to RC ln 3 is the required time. This completes the analysis of 555 timer IC in monostable mode.